Someone had to do it, and thank God it was Ana Navarro. Hi, welcome to JOA. If you're new to my channel, please click subscribe and click the bell so you'll be the first to know when I upload. I'd really appreciate it if you click subscribe, click that bell down below, but follow this. I want you guys to watch this clip, and I'll come back with some more.
Noah being in a bathtub with bubbles and champagne. And look, what am I supposed to do? Throw flares up in the sky, celebrate, drink champagne myself because AOC and Ted Cruz all of a sudden agree on something for 5 hot seconds? In my book, Ted Cruz has blood on his hands, okay? He is one of the protagonists that peddled lies that led to the incitement of people that raided the Capitol and got people killed. People lost their lives because of actions that Ted Cruz took. So there is nothing that he's going to do that I'm going to normalize or that I'm going to applaud. And for the last 2 years, he's been calling Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez a socialist who's going to turn America into Venezuela. So to me, this is a red herring. This is gaslighting so that we don't continue talking about the fact that the Republican Party continues, being beholden to a man that has destroyed the party and continues being the place where whack jobs who are, QAnon conspiracy theorists and a threat to America, like Marjorie Taylor Greene, are finding a home. So I'm not going to focus on Reddit or Robinhood or any of those other terms I don't know. I'm going to focus on the fact that Ted Cruz has blood on his hands, and that's what I care about. And if they're going to agree on anything, let them agree on a COVID relief bill, or let them agree on raising the minimum wage.
Well, let me just jump in really quick why we should care. Just one final thing why we should care. If the stock ends up plunging because of this, because of GameStop, and Wall Street loses billions, at a certain point, it will impact stocks like Apple and Disney and stocks that a lot of average Americans actually do invest in. And if that happens, average Americans will end up losing even more money in right now, all automatically one of the worst economic recessions that we've seen in decades. So we can all say we don't care in one way or another, but at one point in time, this will end up impacting average Americans, and then it's going to reach all the way in all factions of our culture and our society, so we should care a little bit. I know everyone's saying Reddit and all these things don't matter, but they do matter to a lot of people, and it could have. I can hear you laughing, Joy, but there are real bottom line and ramifications for this.
I'm not laughing at you.
Well, I just can hear you laughing in my earpiece.
I'm not laughing at you. No, they want to help because they think
I know that it's millennials doing this, but it does matter. It does matter
because they want to have average Americans figure out how to send a check. Okay, let me say this. There's a very quick way to help average Americans. Send them a check. Send them a check. Agree on how much we're going to send them as a check to help the people who can't pay their rent. Forget about stocks. They can't pay their food bill. So,
I just don't think the COVID relief bill.
Or maybe agree on raising the minimum wage, and then you can lecture me.
I'm not lecturing anyone. I'm not trying to lecture anyone. I just think it's an important story.
So who really gives a damn about GameStop stocks? I saw people on social media talking about it. And right now, dude, we're in a pandemic. 400,000 people passed away due to COVID. A lot of people are being evicted. A lot of people are unemployed. We barely gotten enough stimulus checks for people who are in need, who lost their jobs in the transportation industry, in the food industry. Jobs that people really need. And we're here, we're talking about stocks. Meghan McCain is talking about stocks on national television. Well, that's because the woman was grown with a silver spoon. The woman will never know how it feels to sleep on a floor most of their life like I did. She'll never know how it feels to eat certain type of foods because you can't afford another selected type of foods, or to wear a certain type of clothes because you can't afford certain type of clothes, or certain type of shoes because you can't afford certain type of shoes. This woman is really talking about stocks and how it can affect Apple and Google when in reality we are in a pandemic, and her reality isn't our reality because we weren't born into a silver spoon and our mother isn't a heiress to some beer company, okay? So I don't know what's going on with her. I would really just be interested in the whole explanation as to why she is like this. She's obviously not a Cindy McCain Sydney McCain's daughter. She's obviously not John McCain's daughter. Ana Navarro is at best a John McCain's colleague, because Ana Navarro spent a lot of her time working for John McCain, and Meghan McCain has basically changed over the years when she married to that Neanderthal, Ben Dominass. And so she's not really a McCain. She's more of a dominant. She's more of a radical elitist, and she's more of a morals and principles is basically, you know, flip-flopping and telling lies and worrying about money over really what's really the essence of what's going on, this country being the way it is at the moment due to misrepresentation with the former administration. So it's just, it's odd to me. And I just, I know the reason why, because it's obviously her husband, because Meghan McCain likes to show that she's tough on television, but inside she's really soft and pink. And it seems like, you know, it's kind of like another Wendy Williams type of situation. The husband, I'm sure, is controlling. The husband makes her talking points. Meghan McCain proved it on and on all the time, saying, I have an insider. I have sources. Well, your husband is not a source, okay? He's a plagiarist. Worked for Washington Post. Plagiarized. Got fired. I mean, you know, is a college dropout. Really, his connections is the way you got your connections, through basically through family. And so he's a nobody, just like you, and basically riding on the coattails of being born into a household. Not saying there's something wrong with someone who grew up with a famous family, but I just don't like when people use it for evil. And I think she's using it for evil and he's using it for evil. And so they're no different between Ivanka Trump and Jared Kushner. Just saying. But anyways, let me know what you think in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe and click the bell so you'll be the first to know when I upload. Let me know how y'all liking this, all right? Deuces. Yeah.